And so, looking back, the 42nd Division and the 45th Division claimed that they were the first unit to liberate Dachau. Well, Dachau was a major camp. The main camp of Dachau was had about 30 or 35,000 inmates. Alongside of Dachau, along this highway, what we call the Death Corridor, on the outskirts of Munich, were about 8 or 9 sub-camps. Sub-camps where they had 5,000, normally 5,000 inmates per camp. And there was what we call a feeder camp to the extermination camp, which is the main camp of Dachau. But the diary kept by one of our boys indicate that on April 28, 1945, which is supposed to be the same day that the 42nd and 45th Division claimed that they liberated Dachau, was the day that we opened the gates to a camp of Jewish inmates. Mm-hmm. And we were so involved with moving from, and in that area, I think we stayed about 2 or 3 days. Mm-hmm. But until from Dachau to where we ended up the war, further down south of Munich, there were 8 or 9 other sub-camps, and thousands of these inmates were on the road, starving, dying. You know.
And what did you folks know about the concentration camps?
Very little. You see, we didn't know what it was, except, and besides, they didn't speak English, none of them. You know, all what we saw was these zombies on the road, and some of them dying, and we did whatever we could against the orders. We gave them all the sea rations that we had, you know, and then for a few days, for about 1 week thereafter, wherever we moved from, there were these group of starving people who would wait at the end of our chow line, waiting for the scraps, and you know, we had difficulty eating because we see these starving faces waiting for us to come to the end of the, you know, at the end of the chow line, we have a little sump. And into the sump is a garbage sump. We would dispose of our uneaten food. But these people were already there waiting for us to discard the food into their hands and whatever they had to catch the food from. But it was really an awful sight.